I was wondering whether you'd actually booked the Mini in Italy, the Italian job, just to give you the opportunity to say, you're only supposed to blow the bloody doors off. But I've done it now, so obviously that'll be enough to me.
Do you, Michael Caine? Did you see him in The Dark Knight Rises?
And his voice gets even more emotional than it's ever done in the past before. I don't want to bury you, Batman. I will not put you in the ground in a little box. I will not do it, Master Bruce. I will not do it.
I'm not going to bury another Batman.
Another Batman? How many Batmans has he been buried? How many are there?
I've buried 14 Batmans
so far. I've buried 14 Batmans.
And a little pointy ears in a box.
I'm not going to bury another nylon cloak with pointy ears that people wear at birthday parties.
With a little belt, a very wide belt that
very
is flattering to a man with an expanded girth. I won't do that to you, Master Bruce. I will not do it to you.
And I won't make the voice like that.
The voice goes even like that. He's basically yodeling.
And then Christian Bale says,
she pushes his tongue up her foot. I want to be a Batman. I don't want to be a normal guy.
Bro, you sound deaf.
Just so nobody can recognize him. I can't understand a word you're saying, Master Bruce. Talk to me as Master Bruce, not as Batman.
So he can
have the cloak of anonymity.
But he doesn't sound like he said, here's that bloke in the cloak with who sounds like he's deaf again. It's not anonymous, is it? No wonder when Batman arrives, starts speaking, and everyone starts looking at the shoes. Because they're all thinking, what does he talk like that poor fella? You know?
And what about Tom Hardy? His Bane? Did you catch his
name? He's like, they're competing to see who's the most, the least understandable.
Bane, you're never going to be Bane, you're never going to be
Bane. I swear, I'm going to win.